We are here in Annuello Flora and Fauna Reserve to do a basic inventory survey. So what that means is we just want to find out what's in here. Because Parks Victoria manages over 3,000 reserves, there's no way that we could get around and survey everything that we'd like to. So we do quite heavily rely on citizen scientists, like the Field Nats, to come along and give us a helping hand.
Field Nats Cover Victoria have been operating long before citizen science was a buzzword. You know, that's a buzzword of almost the last 5 years. The FNCV have been operating continuously since 1880. And a lot of those have been just everyday run-of-the-mill people, you know, getting involved in stuff that they're passionate about. It takes a passion to turn up here for a week, you know, live in the dust, etc. and work as hard as we have is a passion.
Okay, so what we're doing here is we're setting up a pit line, which involves a drift fence. Well, the idea of this is that the drift fence directs the animals, whether they be reptiles, mammals, frogs, towards a bucket, which is effectively acts as the trap. So what we're doing at the moment is actually just digging a hole into the ground. So the bucket is slightly below the level of the topsoil, putting the fence across the top of it, pegging the fence into place. And then once that's done, we'll put a cover over the top of the bucket to act as a sun protection, or worst case scenario, to act as a roof in case it rains.
What we're doing here is setting up a drift line with cameras. The reason for using camera techniques is we can determine what's in a place without actually having to catch and handle the animal, which is one of the ethics issues with a lot of other of the techniques.
Hoping to find a range of flora and fauna, fauna in particular, whether they be reptiles, whether they be small mammals or birds, trying to target some of the threatened species that may have occurred or still do occur on the reserve.
Even if we don't find anything, it proves something that they're not in, you know, that animals aren't in the area, so there needs to be more work on conservation to get back what should be here.
We haven't been here long, but we've already got a fairly good bird list, and that includes some threatened and highly significant species. So we've seen Malleefowl on the mound, working their mounds, and that's a fairly iconic species for this landscape. We've already had fairly good numbers of Regent Parrots, which are another rare species. And this morning we just had an incidental chance encounter with a flock of over 400 white-browed wood swallows. So that was pretty cool to see as well.
I would like to see a Mallee emu wren, but I'm told that they're a bit scarce in this area, so my hopes are not very high, but you just never know.
One of the biggest issues for biodiversity management is a lack of information about what's out and about. So I think that's where we make our biggest contribution.
One of the benefits of working in the parks is the local rangers actually get to come and chat to us, and we get a first-hand information about what's happening in the parks and what we're doing is adding to their knowledge of their local areas.
So having partnerships with citizen scientists is really important because it espouses our healthy parks, healthy people philosophy. It basically means that we learn about the health of a park by having the citizen scientists do the fauna surveys, and the healthy people side of it is covered by the physical activity that all participants get in these beautiful areas in the fresh air, performing all the survey work for us. So this is our 11th collaborative project with the Field Nats, and we've already got a whole suite of other projects planned on the calendar to come for the rest of the year and the year after that.